Alrighty, hey guys, and welcome to Black Mirror on the PC. Now, I'm playing with the PS4 controller because I went into the controls. It came up with this, and I'm like, okay, where's the keyboard controls? And that's also an Xbox 360 controller. So, oh, actually, no, it's Xbox One. So yeah, Black Clover, or Black Mirror, sorry, I'm thinking of the anime. Black Mirror, did I say welcome to Black Clover? I'm sorry. Black Mirror is an old game, 2003, I think, or maybe it's a bit later than that, I forget. But it was remade in 2017. Supposedly, there was a three-part game for this. I'm not sure if this is all three games, I think it's only one. But the story takes place around this guy, I forget his name, but his father died, and his father was into the occult. And it's basically all based around investigating his murder, or killing, or whatever. I don't know if he died because he was killed, or died because of old age, or something. But he died, a few weeks around his death were a mystery, and we're trying to figure that out. Now, the original game for this was a point and click. So if you don't know what those are, just think of like, think of League of Legends or something like point and click. You point, you go there. It's a very bad comparison, but you get the point. So I'm wondering what kind of gameplay this is, because from what the Wikipedia page I read, and yes, it was Wikipedia, I'm sorry, I was in a rush. From what I read, the gameplay changed. So I'm wondering what type of gameplay it is. Otherwise, I'm very much looking forward to this game, because I downloaded it a while ago, and the name struck out to me. And the front cover page, if you look it up, it's like a guy on one knee looking down, and it just looks so great. I love the first though. Now I do need to warn you about one thing. This game doesn't have a proper full screen setting, from what I could see. Now everything that's video and below didn't come up until I quit the game once and then came back in, so it's very weird. But the thing is, it doesn't have a proper full screen. It's automatically in borderless. And if I press Alt Enter to put it into windowed, I can't shrink the window down. And what that means is my computer has a little bit of a problem. I've explained this before and I'm going to go into more detail here. But since it will just be a normal window on my screen, but it's borderless, I have a little problem with my computer where a message will come up in the bottom right sometimes saying activate windows. And that's because my computer was hand built by a friend, and I believe that something happened, I don't know. I'm not blaming him, but I believe that because it wasn't professionally made, like by a company and stuff, it went a little wrong. And so every time I try putting in a thing to register Windows 10, it doesn't accept it, but it also doesn't shut down my computer because it's out of date. So it's a little weird. It's like, it keeps on telling me to activate Windows 10, but it doesn't let me activate Windows 10. So for all I know, it's not my friend's fault or anything. It's just a glitch with the computer. But yeah, just so you guys know, a message will come up now and then saying activate Windows 10. And I might not notice it because it's very small. Well, not small, but it's very thin and white. So it might not be seeable sometimes unless it's on a black background. But every time it comes up, I'll try saving my game. I'll try quitting or restarting my computer so it goes away and I'll continue. So you might see it now and then. Just letting you guys know that. Now, I've been talking for a little while now, so I'm going to get into the game, finally. I really like the soundtrack for this menu as well. Anyway, what's extras? I'm just going to go through everything. Puzzles. Art gallery. Oh, this. Ooh, there's 180 different puzzles. And there's different types. That's interesting. We've bet the game, guys. Credits. Okay, new game. Oh, there's no difficulty setting. That's cool. I also like the way the O is. It must have something to do with the game. That's a long loading. See, I'm actually wondering, how did they remake the game? I've never played the original. But maybe people that have played the original might be watching this, and you guys can tell me what the differences are. That was a sudden start.
Him.
Oop. Oh no, I'm controlling him. I don't want to control him in this kind of setting. Okay, so it went from a point and click to this. Oh god, is this going to be like a horror game? What's over here? I can't explore over there. Okay. Oh, okay. I guess we're going on a very linear path here. Do I have any buttons? Pressing everything I can. Oop, I'm in inventory. No, that's just the thing. Doesn't save my game, though. It doesn't pause my game. So, pressing the right on the D-pad does the menu. Doing the left on the menu does the inventory. Doing start does the menu. Doing select does the inventory as well. Okay. Press X to interact. I don't want to. What just happened to us?
I failed you, son. Forgive me. Forgive me. I will let you down no longer. Forgive me. Forgive me.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Is this Until Dawn? Is this how the totems were placed? How do we know it's not coming from the other path? Jeez, I really hope we get to explore this area later. Hi? Hi. Circle. Circle. Square. I don't know what I'm trying to do. Touch. Touch. I saw a circle on it. I'm like, what? Oh god. We just created a banshee. What the fuck was that, man? Okay. I wonder what this game would have been like as a point and click. I can sort of imagine it. But like cutscenes and stuff. Are they all animated?
You betrayed your family.
I didn't betray shit. Take. 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 Ah. No, no, face there. And that looks like the number 4.
You're too late! You will not get him!
Oop. Okay, examine.
Look, it must.
That was quick. I am Flame Man. Nope, I'm dead.
Be safe, my son.
Is that his son? I'm gonna call him Mira. He was in the name's title until I find out his real name. What was the dad's name?
Diary update. I received your last letter. Know that you are missed terribly here in India. If my calculations are correct and the International Postal Service is kind, this letter will keep you company as you make the final leg of your journey to Scotland. I hesitate to say anything for fear you'll think me foolish, even hysterical. Your father made it his life's work to research his family's twisted history. This and his obsession with the occult combined to unravel his poor mind. John loved his family and his family home, but he hated and mistrusted them in equal measure. Son, beware of the Gordons. Blood is not always thicker than water. Your loving mother.
What the hell was with the background there? Okay, I quite like this examining thing here. I wish it was like a cursor, but still. Family of snakes, beware the key. Ooh, what key? There we go. My boy. L and L. Plus the symbol the guy drew, I think, equals a 4 in Roman numerals? And a 9 in Roman numerals equals an M with an X plus that L and L thing. Find the answers, library. My boy. I hope we get to learn this weird language thing. Key. Key. Just, that's what it says. Key.
The ramblings of a madman. I couldn't even bring myself to show this to Mother.
Glad we have a voice. Library. It's if it's upside down and we can't turn it. That's hilarious. I played 999. I know exactly how to turn shit like that.
This countryside.
You looked out the wrong mirror, man. You looked out the fine, whatever. Yeah, let's look at the guard.
Good sir, how much longer until we reach the castle?
Almost there, sir.
Thank you.
2 hours ago. The estate really does lie off the beaten track.
Jesus. What else can we look at? You look pretty cool. I like how we look, honestly. That's the main thing that got me into this game. The guy on the front cover's look. Oh, we can look in the box. Yeah, I can definitely see how this would be a point-and-click game. Examine. What's this? Examine. Resembles a tower. Now it's upside down because I'm an idiot.
A note about a library. A key and some sort of. Should I even try to read any real meaning into all of this?
I mean, it might help, honestly.
A note about a library.
Okay,
a key,
okay. And
some sort of.
I can move it around.
Toy. Should I even try to read any real meaning into all of this?
As I said, maybe. I just put
we
it into my stomach.
We have arrived, sir.
Your tutorial is done. Now begins the other tutorial. THQ Nordic presents. I think THQ are the same people that made Darksiders. King Art Games Production. Black Mirror. Yeah. What the hell?
Welcome, Mr. Gordon. I'm Andrew Harrison.
Mr. Harrison, it's good to finally meet you. From our correspondence, I expected you to be older.
Thank you. I'll lead the way. It's quite dark already. We can continue to talk inside.
I mean, you could also get your subtitles right. I'm not gonna like these long loading screens. I'm really not. Hello? Anyone there, darkness? Thank you. Yes, I am Lord Vampire Girl.
He's arrived, my lady.
He has arrived.
David, welcome to Skahandu House.
Skahandu? There's no Jew in there.
Lady Margaret, how kind of you to welcome me in person at such a late hour.
Oh!
An impressive building. Skahandu, though.
Oh, do as in like, yeah.
What is its meaning?
Unusual only if you have not bothered to study Gaelic. It means Black Mirror House.
Your
Many
credits.
Generations of the Gordon family have been master of this house. It is a great responsibility. Perhaps the greatest a man could bear.
Father's
If I may, I would like to know more about my father's last days.
It is too late in the day for such morbid talk.
But she might go down as night.
You do look so very much like John, though.
Oh, so his name was John.
Angus,
my name?
Please show Master David to his room.
Ah, David, right.
Yes, ma'am.
Sprite's pretty nice in this game.
This place is rather remote, even for Scotland.
It was most pleasing, thank you. I was fortunate enough to stop off in several fascinating places on my way here. How long have you been practicing law?
I came to the bar a few years ago. I'm at Chambers in Edinburgh with lawyers who have served the Gordon family for generations. I'm embarrassed to ask, but it is my job. Have you proof of who you say you are? You are David Gordon, son of the late John Gordon.
Please, I quite understand. Here you are.
Hand over documents.
What a curious object.
Truth.
It belonged to my father. He posted it to me shortly before his death. I'm not at all sure what it is.
Perhaps it's something else returning home where it belongs. Like its new owner. Have a good night, Master David. I shall continue my studies.
I don't see the point of lying about
Please
that.
Please follow me. Master David?
Can I explore the house? I want to explore the house, man. It's very dark, though. I can't go in there.
Please, sir, I advise you to do as your grandmother instructed and get some sleep.
Yeah, not the boss of me. You're no Alfred. I'll sleep on the couch, I guess.
I have a question for Andrew. I'll just be a moment.
Andrew will still be there in the morning, Master David.
But I might not.
Please respect Lady Margaret's wishes.
You're right. Tomorrow is another day.
Yeah, another day. If we wake up.
I've annoyed the old fellow enough. First impressions count.
This way, sir.
I know. I'm an explorer. What's this?
I've annoyed the old fellow enough.
Oh.
First impressions count, although they don't seem too worried about my first impression of them.
Alright, let's follow the guy. Hey, ma'am. I'm here. Is this John? It's John.
Your grandfather, his lordship Edward Gordon.
Cool.
There is no denying it. We are family. Somebody still cares. Maybe you weren't as bad as Mother believed.
I'm guessing he has a bad reputation with his mother. Probably her father. Probably from his father's side then.
Grandfather Edward. Father never spoke of you, but Mother never had a kind word to say. You were the worst of the lot, she said.
Now, I do know his parents were, well, his father at least was into a cult.
These are
so maybe
all family
members? The mother hated that?
Yes, sir. The Gordons are one of the oldest families in Scotland.
Interesting. So I'm guessing
please,
we lived
sir,
with...
I advise you to do as your grandmother instructed.
At least I can skip those. I'm guessing we lived with our mother, and that's why we don't know this place, because we didn't know our father as much. But our father knew we would be connected to all this
if
shit.
If you would be so kind as to follow me, sir.
Take?
Pieces of some kind of drawing. How odd.
What? Letter from David's feather, unfollow. Nope. Oh, it's a reading thing. I think this is not one we've read. Because we've read the one from the mother before, but this is something different. The trip from India was a long and arduous one. I was reluctant to leave mother on her own. Alone coping with my father's death, I was a child when he moved us to India, announcing it would be a better environment for us. This, however, was not the case. Though I had always been curious to see the ancestral home of the Gordon clan with my own eyes, my father was quick to point out that a house is not a home. While Grandmother Margaret's primary concern seemed to revolve around matters of me inheriting the estate, I am more interested in the circumstances of my father's demise. Even in the face of his many years of absence from our lives, admittedly not his only vice, I feel as if there is a shadow obscuring much, if not most, of what happened in his final days and weeks. He spent most of my youth traveling, searching for answers. His gin-fueled melancholy was linked with his twin possessions, the Gordon family history and the occult. Answers to I know not what. He did not confide me much in what my father, my mother, or myself. Then he simply did not return. I fear that I am, perhaps, overthinking as always, as my tutors would no doubt delight in reminding me. My proclivity to blend imagination with reality would not help answer any of the questions waiting for me at the house. Well, I mean, as far as you know, they might. So we can't change pages. Okay. Follow the butler to your room. Got it.
Your
I don't know what that piece was.
This way.
Thank you. I hope this isn't Deus Ex Mission 1, where, the longer I wait, the worse.
I suppose it's hard to keep things dry, but with all the rain you get here.
Most amusing, Master David. We do our best, sir. None of us are as young as we used to be.
Yeah, it's a little disappointing.
Magnificent.
That is the master's study, sir, but there'll be plenty of time to examine it in the light tomorrow.
The reason this game's called Black Mirror means it's gonna be all black, man. Not looking forward to that, actually. I like seeing things in the light. Actually, I hope it's not going to be all dark.
I've annoyed the old fellow
enough. It's another area.
First impressions count.
Hey.
Huh?
It does that sometimes, sir.
Hmm, interesting. Something was watching us. Quest log updated.
Lady Gordon expects you for breakfast at 8, sir.
Thank you. Lady Gordon called you Angus? Pleased to meet you, Angus.
Yes, sir. She did. I am Mr. McKinnon.
Mr. McKinnon, yes.
I'd advise you not to leave the room tonight. Ticking clocks are not the worst thing you may encounter in the house at night, if you don't know your way around. Sleep well, sir.
Morbid.
Maybe he's more of a morning person.
Alright, we have a pretty nice place. I like it. I quite like it. Okay, let's see what the quest log is. Follow the bullet to your room. Explore the castle. Okay, let's get used to the buttons. Diary is up. Okay. Quest log is down. Inventory is right. Menu is left. Got it. What's this?
I got somewhat turned around following Angus through the house. Sorry, Mr. McKinnon. But I think my room is probably around here somewhere.
Yeah, we went up. So we came in. You can't see my mouse. Well, you can't see anything. I'm not even pointing. I'm just imagining it. Came in through the front entrance. I'm assuming the big entrance room is right beyond that. We went up the stairway over here. We came around, came back, and then we're in the far room.
Hold on. This looks like... Wait a moment. This is a piece of a model.
Interesting.
I doubt this place could ever be properly warm. This room has to be next to mine. Is this what Father was trying to tell me with the trinket he sent me? This room ha-
How would he know we get this room, though? Unless these people are planning things and he knows what they're planning, that's why they're putting us into this room.
More pieces of the same drawing. Maybe I can make out what it shows if I had enough of them.
That would be good.
The candle is nearly gone, but it should do for a while once lit. The candle is...
Okay. I was about to say, it's better if I could move the camera more. But you can. It's just that you can't move it all the way around. Okay, I'm guessing that's used the bed.
Glad I don't have to carry you around anymore. Mr. McKinnon lifted you up with ease.
Telegram.
This handsome, cheery, sober man. He's not the one I remember from my childhood.
Is he your father?
Not many matches left.
5.
I should get a new passport. This one's filling up. Without some obscure local law that required me being here in person, I would probably never have come. A pigeon amongst the cats.
Sorry to inform you of death of John Gordon. Stop. Please return to Skahundu House. Stop. Andrew Harrison, lawyer. Stop.
I'm guessing that's how they used to write telegrams, because it stopped because they want to go to a new line. That's interesting.
Everything I ever owned could fit in there, 5 times over.
Well, that's actually pretty sad, but okay, man. I won't try leaving.
I'm going to need a light to find my way about out there.
Oh! Oh, we can use the light. You can use the candle.
I can barely see my hand in front of me.
Okay, then. Is there a save button? Yeah, there is. Light.
Ah, just what I need.
Alright, I'm gonna save. Anyway, let's leave. What is out here?
We meet again, old foe.
Okay, so I'm getting a little worried that the reason we shouldn't walk out here is because we might have to...
Big enough to fit your own weight and food into.
We might have to replay the game, knowing which ways to go. Like, maybe going through the wrong door will teach us something bad.
Barging into someone's bedroom in the middle of the night is not how to earn their trust.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm not going to take any risks. I'm going to go back to my room. And I'm going to try going through that other door.
Father must have left something for me in the master's study. I suppose I could ask Mr. McKinnon to open it for me in the morning, but I'll have him breathing down my neck. And who knows what I'm to find.
I'm sure your dad was smart enough to know that. Go.
I will put your high praise of Scottish water to the test, Father. Later.
Wait, what? Okay. Guess I'll just go to
my
bed.
My faithful friend Insomnia. I wonder if Andrew has left the library yet.
Oh, we have to leave anyway. Okay. I wonder if there will be a death thing in this game. Just gonna save again. I'm walking automatically.
No, this isn't right. There should be a room here.
Do nothing. No, this keep listening.
What I need either. Where is it? Eavesdropping, Mr. Gordon? That's hardly proper.
Is this what Father meant by a family of snakes?
Wouldn't it be more comfortable working here?
That's Lady Gordon's private desk. It would be improper for me to use it.
Oh, okay. That's a desk. Lady Gordon would be my mother? Or is she the old lady?
Despair, by a man called Howard Phillips Lovecraft.
Ghastly shades of bygone gladness, clawing fiends of future sadness, mingle in a cloud of madness.
There's a H.P. Lovecraft thing in this.
Thus the living, lone and sobbing, in the throes of anguish throbbing, with the loathsome furies robbing night and noon of peace and rest. But beyond the groans and grating of abhorrent life is waiting sweet oblivion, culminating all the years of fruitless quest.
The words of a troubled soul.
Yeah, very troubled indeed. Peaceful life in oblivion?
The Castle of Otranto by Horace Walpole. I started reading this, though never got round to finishing it.
The gentle maid whose hapless tale these melancholy pages speak, say, gracious lady, shall she fail to draw the tear adown from thy cheek?
Maybe, who knows?
Ghosts, legends, ancient history. Where's the rest of them?
Alright, well, I'll leave you, Andrew. I'll come down to you after I check out other areas of the house. What the fuck? What the hell? Alright, can't go in there.
Shame. Attics often speak volumes about the owners of a house.
Alright. Now, well, I do know that you unlock more areas of the house as the game continues, so I'm not going to be sad about it. Alright. Door that doesn't become interactable. Let's re-examine this again. Nope. Though so far this game doesn't seem to have any horror elements. It just has thriller. It's a little disappointing, but also good. Because I'm not really that good of a person when it comes to horror. I'm very squeamish when it comes to scary things. So...